Alright guys, what's going on? It's Reefly. You guys watching Middle Earth Shadow of Mordor. And last time, what did we do? We did some main story missions with Lafriel, or whatever her name is. Lifrel, I don't know. We had to rescue her from a stronghold. We got our execution unstoppable mode going a few times, and we took on a few war chiefs. Got pretty lucky with one of them. Actually, pretty much all of them I've gotten lucky compared to every time where I actually fought them and I was skilled. But we're gonna hopefully get the last one here.
You won't suffer long. We're efficient killers.
Okay.
Nasty Uruk's turning against us? Off with you!
This guy looks pretty tough, actually. That guy has information. I want information. I can actually betray him too. All right. Betrayal. Dang it. All right. What is he weak against? Fear of Caragors and combat finishers.
Just great. Big mistake you made, yes. No time to regret it, though. Not before you're dead.
Shut up. You can't jump over him. I didn't read that. There's like a Caragor around here you can scare him off with. No. I need to drain somebody. He's retreating already!
I'll kill you next time, you filth!
I'm so angry. I wish this was more difficult. Not. We gotta hop over that rock. Speed boost. Yeah. No, wait, this isn't the captain, is it? No, it's not. Give me intel on... He's under our control. Now this guy's under our control. Who's with him? There's a guy in the back. Look, it's pointing to somebody in the background. How am I supposed to get to that person? Oh my god. Well, I don't know. You guys, you can give me intel on a random guy up here. Well, I thought that was a captain, but I guess not. We should win. I mean, it's 3 or 4 against 1, technically. We got 3 captains. And a war chief. No, dang it. Yeah, I got 2 combat finishers now. That doesn't work. And now he's retreating.
Another day.
No, this is bad timing game. He's actually stronger than Ishka. Oh, he's fast. It was like, what's that one movie? I can't remember. The one with McLovin. You know what I mean. Oh, he's not weak enough. That's right. No, I don't want to kill. Damn it. Well, hopefully one of my guys takes over. Yeah, okay, it worked out in the end. The singer is back up there. He's in the main stage. All war chiefs dominated. Whoa, you fell on my sword, dude. You gotta watch out for that. That's dangerous. There you go. Okay. All war chiefs are under our command. We are basically unstoppable right now. No, we're not. I still suck at the game. Am I, like, right by it? What is that? Is that me? I don't know. Is Ishka the fool? Okay. We're right by it, so we can just run there. Alright, that only took 6 minutes. Actually, a little bit more of that I wanted to do, but... What?! How'd you die, dude? Alright, let's turn this up. Your focuses await your forces await your command. The time has come to launch your assault against the Black Hand.
We wish to thank you for coming to our aid, Captain.
Aye. Never realized my smuggling could be so appreciated by the Queen. Lady.
They're here.
Orcs. Oh, they make bad passengers. But I've carried worse. The lady. Keep that plank level. Oi, touch nothing.
Queen Marwyn. It's good to see you in better health.
The boats are ready. The skippers have been briefed on your destination.
Good.
How long will those orcs obey you?
Well, I should think as long as I like. I'm in your debt.
We owe you our lives, Talion.
Just put an end to this madness.
My lady.
Okay, now this is where the game starts to feel really rushed, especially the story. Because it just jumps from thing to thing, and there's really... It seems like they could have just expanded it longer and gotten rid of the stupid, like, hunting missions with Torvin. Tuca Swordmaster. So this is their nemesis, which I think is actually the person who's killed you the most. So it's Tuca Bloodmaster or whatever. I'm at a very weak point right now where I should have more, like, I think I'm supposed to call up my war chiefs. But I tried to have my own account and I had no clue what it meant by summon your war chiefs. I went and did the mission, and nothing happened. I didn't know what to do. It said interrogate them, and it never told you what to do. So that's why I didn't even bother this time to do it. I don't know what my cat, my war chiefs are doing over there. We're just kind of chilling. Pop his head. Yeah, I think Tuka's he's the one who's invulnerable to combat finishers. That's right. So he's the worst because I can't freaking stealth kill him. I want to make sure, though, just in case. Maybe they nerfed him a bit. I think we did. Yeah, he's not invulnerable to a lot of stuff now. Good.
This is your legacy, Ranger. A broken vessel for a lost soul.
Shut up. You're the one who's gonna die. Congratulations, you're dead. Guess what? It comes with nothing but eternal damnation.
You lose.
We are at the final reckoning, the fortress of the Black Hand.
All right. Let's go talk and find a blind, or not really talk. We're gonna go kill him. Let's go find that Black Hand. I almost said Blind Hand.
Sorcery is at work here.
But I think it's cool how if it like the person who's killed you the most at the end of the game, it's cool.
I wasn't expecting you. I hope my soldiers gave you a welcome.
Where are you? Show yourself!
This is the work of the Tower.
The Black Hand went looking for you. But it will give me great pleasure to take you myself. Forgives you, Celebrimbor. Return to him and cast off this human corpse.
Stand up and fight.
There's no need, Ranger. Celebrimbor is your curse. He chose you.
Silence!
And he can release you at any time. Yes, that's all you are, Ranger. A vessel for the ring. As you wish.
So this fight is pretty lame.
Such pain, such a broken mind.
You basically just stealth attack him a few times and it's over. Yeah. It's not that entertaining. It doesn't really even make any sense. You think a name Like, with a name like Vatower, he would just be, like, a melee beast, but he's, like, some weird teleporting, like, psychological person. That was easy. I will. That was pretty brutal, I must admit.
You said we were cursed. You deceived me.
It was Sauron's doing.
This was your doing!
I should have died with my family.
I thought you wanted revenge. I can't leave you. But there is only one way to close the circle. Black Hand remains.
Not for long.
Loading. So that fight was just, it was really underwhelming. It wasn't even, like, difficult at all. Like, if you're gonna make it stealth, I guess you could make it more difficult, but it wasn't, like, I beat him in a minute, I think. I'd much rather have just done a classic, just fight him in an arena kind of thing. But whatever. Complete.
The room is in flames. We must return to Queen Marwyn.
The Black Hand has been here. I can feel it.
Lothariel.
Alright, let's go there. So yeah, like I've been mentioning, the game just, you jump to the next thing, just like a click of the finger. It's just, it's not a snap of the finger. They really could have just, you know, kind of pulled it out more and just kind of replaced the meaningless missions we've done. So yeah, this is, we can't go back after this. So yeah, I guess I'm gonna keep playing.
Zun Ishi Kring Patrol.
That's not the thing you bit your ring on, I'm just saying.
Thief! It was mine to keep!
Be gone.
Okay, we rode here on that. I don't know how. Don't know how long it took. Who cares? Okay, a few things I want to touch on. Hey, why was Gollum there? He just disappeared from the story, and we're like, okay, just throw him here. Just put him there, and just have him give us this thing, and yeah, everybody else is dead, but Gollum's there for some reason. And they didn't kill him. It doesn't make any sense. And then he hit the ring on the wrong finger. That's not where you put the ring on. It's supposed to be your, like, your ring finger, not your index finger. But he had the ring for a little bit. Which, people who are really into the lore of Lord of the Rings probably want to shoot themselves after seeing this or something. Or maybe it's totally legit. I guess I don't know.
I come for you, Lord of Gifts.
Alright, so this next fight is actually kinda... It actually isn't that tough. So you just let your teammates do everything. First Talon of the Hand. No, don't run away, you idiot! Okay, no, he's pissed off now.
Tower. I'll mount your head on the spikes of the Black Gate for what you did to him.
I don't think so. So yeah, you verse basically four... I want to say war chiefs. It might just be one war chief and a cap and some captains, but there's some tough dudes. And this is what I did most of the time. I just kind of just hung back on here and just kind of hit some stuff. But we got a Monster Slayer dude here who kind of sucks. Hates burns. Alright, there he's dead. Third Talon of the Hand. So you actually have enough people here that They actually take care of quite a bit of these enemies. In my opinion, they do. Whoa, that I probably shouldn't. No, I guess I had to kill you then. I was gonna just control you, but you're gonna haunt my nightmares. Alright, you lost your head. That's the fourth hand. This guy's only weak against executions, apparently. They killed the first half! I didn't have to do anything. Nice. It's kind of hard to see. You guys just handle. I'll just stay back here. Kill some of the little minions here, and you just take care of those tough dudes. Oh, this Fur Talon dude wants a piece of me. He's the last one, though. See, they do everything! Like, this is why this is actually kinda easy. Otherwise, it'd be really difficult. Ooh, you lost your head. And you're almost dead. I'm gonna shoot you, pin you to the ground, and you're dead.
Talk, scum. Sauron, kill you.
That's not proper English. You deserve to die for that. There goes your head. Cool. We'll pick up all these runes then. Yeah, so that was not that difficult. This actually isn't as long as I thought it was.
This will finish as it started, with shadow and flame falling on the Black Gate. The Hammer and the Tower are dead. Sauron is still weak. Without the power of the One Ring or the Ringmaker, he cannot take form. He will be trapped within Mordor, no more than an eye of flame bound to his dark tower.
And at last I can die, and none will avenge me.
All right. Unlock some abilities, I guess. We'll do that, I guess. It actually doesn't matter, to be honest. You'll see why. You'll see. This.
A gift for you, Celebrimbor.
I wish we could do that.
Lord gave you a second chance to stand by his side. Now I give you no choice. We shall be sealed together in death.
So be it.
Return to me, Ringmaker.
I died because I was trying to turn on my mic. See you later, punk. Hasta la vista, baby. Ooh, through the head.
Talion, my heart. We will be together soon. Forever.
Sauron is dead. The hither shore is calling us. This is no longer our battle. I tried fighting him. It can't be done. Could you really rest for all of eternity, knowing that you had the chance to stop him, but did nothing? The time has come for a new ring.
So that's Middle Earth Shadow Mordor. So they're basically just setting up right for a sequel. So we're gonna go make a new ring, which is probably doesn't make any sense in the actual lore, but it should be interesting, especially in the next game. But like I was saying, the ending just feels extremely rushed. Like, you don't even fight, like, the last two bosses, really. And everything just seems to be like, okay, you kind of just teleport here, you teleport to there. You really don't actually, like, do it. Like, the rest of the game, you're doing stuff you really should just be teleporting to. So I feel like the ending was really rushed. Overall, the story... it has interesting points, but they just... he just kind of missed a little bit. We just need more interesting kind of story missions, I should say. I think I like Talion as a character. He's pretty cool. I think that the whole Kellan Brimbor thing is, it's cool, but I feel like we're just not doing what we should be doing. And then now, with the sequel, it's probably even more ridiculous, but I guess I'm not really complaining, because I do want a sequel of this game, no doubt about it. Like, I enjoy this game a lot. It's, I'd say it's probably cracked my top 5 favorite games from 2014. It has a lot of great stuff. The combat's fantastic. Absolutely, I love the combat. So good. The Nemesis system is really cool. I'd like them to add a little bit more to it in the next game. I I mean, upgrade system was cool. I mean, you got cool upgrades. Like, once you got to, like, the third tier of upgrades, you really got some good stuff that just really made combat a lot more fun. Especially in the sequel, you're going to get a new ring, so you probably are going to be super powered beyond belief. What else? I just say, really, this game is just... It lives and dies by its gameplay, and the gameplay is really good. It's on par with the Arkham series combat. No doubt. And the story just needs to be better. And otherwise, this game would probably be like a 9+ game for me. But yeah, so that'll wrap it up for the main story. As I mentioned in like parts 14 or 15, I'm still uncertain about side missions if I'll do all of them because of all the issues I've been having. But if I am going to do it, you'll see it after this part. So basically, if I do all the side stuff, I'll just keep uploading it after the ending here. So look forward to that if I am doing it. If not, I apologize that I said 100% and I'm not doing that. It's just stuff happened and I couldn't 100% it. So, but yeah. If I had to give us a rating out of 10, I said, and I think in the last part, this game ranges from a 7.5 to me to like a 9. So I guess I'll say like an 8.25 just to be in the middle. It does a lot of things well, like I said. The combat's great, but the story just needs to work on. And there's just some things in the game that just irritate the hell out of me. Especially like mission structures and stuff like that. I wish they did more just like kind of War Chief missions, but made it more cinematic, like he's just following an army or something and it's raining and it's just more cinematic. It's in a huge castle or some bullshit like that. I wish they would do that in the next game. And still, you know, you can still have like the regular War Chief missions like they had in this game, but for main story missions, just make it more cinematic, really. Good music. The music was pretty solid. We kind of threw in some characters, like I said, also. So maybe we'll flesh them out more in the next game. But yeah, it was a fun game. If you haven't picked this up, pick it up. I would recommend it because it's more fun to play the game and to watch it. Even though the combat looks fun, it plays more funner. It's funner to combat when you play it yourself. So I'm done rambling. That's it for the main story. So yeah. So I've been briefly just watching Miller Shadow of Mordor. Want to thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you watched all the videos. And I'll see you guys around for maybe side stuff, like I said. And in about 2 weeks, I'll be starting up Sunset Overdrive. So, if you're interested in that game, just check it out in a few weeks. And I got Assassin's Creed Unity planned, and I think that's it for what I have planned. I might do with Evil Within, which comes out in a few days, but that's besides the point. So, thanks for watching, guys and gals and animals. I'll see you guys later. The ring, my precious, my precious. That was a really bad Golem voice. I probably just destroyed your ears. I apologize. Thanks for watching. See you guys later.